before, but you may not realize it right away. Here we did positive minus positive. Let's do negative minus positive. Negative number minus a positive number. So the example that we might have there would be something like negative 3 minus 4. So here's a negative 3, that's a negative number. We're subtracting a positive number from it. And what I want to point out to you, though, before we even get to this is the same as something you've already seen before. It's the same as negative 3 plus negative 4. Because remember, I told you, anytime you see plus and negative, it's the same thing as subtraction. And we have done this type of problem. We have done that type of problem in the last section, adding two integers together. And I told you, anytime you have a negative plus a negative, the answer is always negative. So you add them together, which is 7, and you stick a negative out front. The answer is negative 7. So the answer to this problem, which is exactly the same thing, is negative 7. Now, to understand where that's coming from, let's draw it on a number line. Okay, let's say this is 0 here. Negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, and negative 7. And let's say that I'm starting off at negative 3 because that's how my problem is. I start here and I have to take away 4 from that. So I go this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. Negative 7. Okay, now let's try another quick problem that would fit this mold. So let's say we had negative 1 minus 5. Negative 1 minus 5. Well, if you can kind of visualize that number line, you're going to have negative 1, and you're going to subtract 5 more. So you're going to be getting this way. You're going to be going this way even more negative. So you're going to be at negative 6 when it's all over. And just to refresh your memory, that's because you're going to, if this is 0, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, and negative 6 over here, then if you were going to do something like this, you'd be starting at negative 1. This is the starting point, and you're going to subtract 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're going to land on negative 6. So just as we said before, we're going to be going more and more negative. Let's do one more quick one like this. So negative 2 minus 8. Well, if you can visualize negative 2 being here on the number line, and you're going to go 8 more to the left, you're going to be sliding this way. So you're going to end up on negative 10. So you're adding these numbers together, and you're sticking a negative sign. Same thing we're doing here. Same thing we're doing here. We're just adding them up and putting a negative. And that's because it's exactly the same thing as negative 2 plus a negative 8. And we said, and addition of negative plus negative, we just add the numbers together, and we stick a negative sign on there. So I don't think I need to draw the number line again, because you can imagine if you were over here at negative 2, you would count 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're going to land at negative 10. All right, so there's one more case.